BJP leader Tarun Vijay. Mr. Vijay, thank you for joining us on Headlines today. This is something, would you think that it echoes exactly what the BJP has been saying all along, sir?
Of course, the government has been known for its political approach towards the policies and the complete lethargy towards the public good. They have been solely responsible for a leaderless economy and dwindling value of the rupee. Like the God's particle, the government has become almost invisible and nobody knows who is governing this country. The country never faced this kind of a leaderless governance where the terrorists are striking at liberty, prices are soaring high, common man is simply groping for any succor, and there is no relief for the people. Corruption and devaluation of rupee, this has impacted on the investments and the flight of money from outside. So neither the foreign investors are investing money in India, nor the Indian investors are any more interested to put their money here. They are going to China, to other European countries, America, but not in India. So this is the sorry state of the country, and unfortunately, the two so-called financial wizards, one is the CEO, Dr. Manmohan Singh, and the other, the finance minister, erstwhile Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, they are now becoming the symbol of a country which is in shambles.
You know, Mr. Vijay, at this point of time, this article where Manmohan Singh, the Prime Minister of India, is on the front page of the Times magazine, do you think it gives out completely the wrong message? Because you are at a time where the economy is facing a complete paralysis at one end, you are looking for investment, and a message like this going out to the world?
I would like to compare it with the a couple of months back, Time magazine had put Narendra Modi on the front page and said that he means business. Modi means business. That's what BJP stands for. We are for prosperity, for security, for development, and for the common man's good. Power to everyone, infrastructure for everyone's good. But here, again, Time magazine has put another Indian Manmohan Singh on the cover. And what it shows? It shows that the Indian economy is in shambles, the country is getting to the dark, and the rupee is devaluing. There is no hope for the common people. So this is the contrast between the two parties, two leaders, and this is the contrast between the approach of BJP and the Congress. And we are very sorry to say that the country's image has taken a downslide because of these leaders. Everyone in the world now thinks of India in terms of corruption, in terms of bad economy, in terms of bad governance, and in terms of leaderless country.
All right, Tarun Vijay, thank you for joining us. There are continuous reactions coming in on Headlines today. On the phone line with us is Janata Party President Subramaniam Swamy. So thank you for talking to Headlines today. Your first comments on what you see on your television screen, sir.
Well, I think as far as Mr. Manmohan Singh's professional qualification is concerned, it is not in. What is important is to know is that talent is not in short supply in India. The question, therefore, is whether he has done the right thing by being so passive, submissive, and spineless in office. Mr. Manmohan Singh really doesn't deserve the credit of being the initiator of reforms. It's actually Mr. Narasimha Rao, who had the political authority and the savvy to get it done. And the blueprints were prepared by me in the previous government of Mr. Chandrasekhar. So, but he did execute it, and that's his strength. If he's given support, he would have done extremely well. But he was blocked by the fact that there was another more powerful source of power in the UPA government, which was headed by Ms. Sonia Gandhi. And she was a populist-minded person. And this gentleman, therefore, had to bend every time. And in the end, he has created a mess in the country and destroyed our legacy for the last 20 years.